Thanks for listening to the Made to Fuel podcast. Don't forget to click the subscribe button so you don't ever miss an episode. Feel free to stay social with me on Instagram at MadeFitnessCT. Search Made to Fuel podcast to find the show on iTunes, Spotify, and iHeartRadio. Every episode is 10 minutes or less, so you can listen multiple times to fuel you throughout each week. Spread the message and share the podcast with anyone in your life to help fuel them too. Now, let's get into it. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Made to Fuel podcast. Thank you guys for clicking on the episode. We are taking a little break from the Behind the Drive series, but I do hope that you have been enjoying the content and interviews with these unique individuals that I've had an opportunity to speak with on how they make a positive impact and hold themselves accountable to do great things day in and day out. That series will continue soon, but for now, we're going back to our old school round of episodes here. And I just wanted to do a little reflection episode. Since quarantine began and this whole pandemic started, a lot has been going on in the world. And I'm sure for you personally, there's definitely been a lot going on for me. And I wanted to talk a little bit about my experience and thoughts coming out of this quarantine, but still dealing with the pandemic. So for one, when the quarantine all started, everything shut down. Now, I'm based in Connecticut, so the East Coast, we got hit really hard. Connecticut, we're right near New York, New Jersey, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and New York got hit heavy with it, and we definitely felt the impact. So we went into that strict shutdown for 2 weeks, and everybody kind of freaked out. Being a physical education teacher, we had to do the virtual learning and teaching. So that was a transition that took a little bit of time to get comfortable with. And my gym closed. So I wasn't able to coach classes. And at that time, we were not doing any virtual trainings. So I made the decision to start doing some workouts on Instagram Live. And I didn't plan on doing them on a weekly basis. I did one on a random Thursday that started to pick up a little bit of interest. And the feedback was great, and I'm very thankful for the feedback because it did lead to me starting to do free Instagram Live workouts 3 days a week. And in part, this was a way for me to give back. A lot of my clients at my gym work for Yale in New Haven, so they're always at the hospital and they're on the front line. And it was a way for me to kind of give them a little bit of sanity, a little bit of stress relief so that when they finished their shift or found time throughout the course of the week to get a workout in, hopefully it made them feel better mentally and physically. So this has gone on from the beginning of quarantine and the pandemic, about 2.5 to 3 months in, and then things started to open back up again, including my gym. So when my gym opened back up, they respectfully asked me if I would want to do virtual classes for them, which means that I'd have to no longer offer the free Instagram Live workouts. And my gym has an amazing community that I'm proud to be a part of. So I told them that I want to coach classes for them. This kind of put the people that were doing my workouts in a little bit of an uproar because they were like, hey, what about us? Like, we're not members of your gym. We don't necessarily live close to that gym, so it doesn't really make sense for us to sign up to that gym just to do virtual workouts. We still want to just kind of work out with you. And that led to the launch of my website on May 22nd, which is madefitnessct.com, where I offer unlimited on-demand workouts anywhere, anytime. And I'm now going to be offering free live weekly classes, at least for the summer, once a week. They're going to be random days and times to try to adapt to everybody's different schedules. But if you're unable to participate during the live workout, then it automatically goes into the archive and becomes on demand so that you can do it at your convenience anytime, which is cool. The best part was, you know, I had the opportunity to do some self-reflection once my gym opened back up and once I had the idea that I wanted to create the website, but there had to be more to it. And I thought about all the friends, the family members, the clients colleagues and coworkers that got hit from the pandemic, whether it was having a family member or friend ill that wound up having coronavirus. They might have passed away from coronavirus. They might have lost their job or got furloughed, and financially they hit a bit of a struggle. They might have been a business owner and their business was being affected by this pandemic. You know, there was a lot of question marks, a lot of negative things that were happening, and that was where I wanted to do my best to turn a negative into a positive. Exercise has always been an outlet for me. It's been a stress relief. It's something that always makes me feel better when I'm down, or even if I'm, you know, feeling fine that day, it makes me feel even better. You never regret a workout. As cheesy as that quote is, it's so true. So one way that I can give back was by making my workouts as cost-effective as possible to anyone that would be interested in joining my website. So I created a subscription for under $8 a month. And within that first month, I posted 50 workout videos. Now, y'all, let me tell you something. It is incredibly challenging and difficult to work out by yourself in silence. I couldn't put music on while I was doing these workouts so that you can hear me effectively and clearly. And then this way I can put the music on while I'm editing the video so that I can set the volume so that my voice isn't necessarily battling the volume of the music. So I did this for 50 workouts within a little over a month. And it was insane. And I knew that I wanted to show the members, like, hey, you know, I'm doing this, but I'm doing this and I'm going all out. As a trainer, it's our job to deliver, right, for our clients, to make sure that we're writing workouts towards your goals, protecting you so that you don't get hurt. When it came to creating this website and creating these workouts, I knew that I couldn't necessarily just deliver. I had to over-deliver for my members so that they understood that this isn't a temporary thing. This isn't a half-assed type of thing. This is me going to over-deliver and let you see that I'm going to constantly put out as much content as often as I can so that this way the workouts don't become stale to you. You don't fall off track. You can maintain accountability and you can maintain the focus to stay active, to keep up with the workouts, and to not lose sight of your goals moving forward. I coach you through every step of the way. That's another thing that was important to me, not only to motivate you, but I want to guide you through every single movement and give you these reminders, but more importantly, coach you through every step of the way. And again, over deliver for you. So I'm trying to provide one of the most positive, interactive, accountable communities. It's just digitally, right? You have all of these gyms that are big box gyms, small box gyms, corporate gyms. They could be studios or other virtual on-demand workout programs. I wanted to make sure whatever programs I was putting out was going to be as effective as possible as far as the workouts go and your wallet, your bank account. I want it to be cost effective. You know, fitness should not come at a high price. Wanting to better yourself, improve yourself mentally and physically should not come at a high cost. And there should be multiple options for you to do that. So that was the main drive behind the website. And that's why I decided to do it, because I knew that there was nothing or nobody holding me back and I can do it the way that I intend to do it, which again would be to over deliver to the people who need it the most, especially through these tough times. So check it out, madefitnessct.com. I'm on Instagram at madefitnessct. So you guys, if you have any questions ever that you want to talk to me about, you could always hit me up on Instagram. You can email me right through the website and we can figure out what the best plan of attack is for you moving forward. But I wanted to share that story with you guys. If you're not coming out of this quarantine in better shape with a new hobby or being able to do something for yourself, then I ask you, what did you do with all that extra free time that you had during quarantine, during lockdown, during this pandemic? It's not too late to make an impact. So as we move forward and we get a little bit closer, hopefully, to some kind of normalcy, when you go back into that state of mind, what are you going to show that you improved on? And I'll leave you guys with that. Thank you guys so much for listening. As always, if there's anyone in your life that you think could benefit from today's episode, please feel free to share this with them. They can find us pretty much anywhere now at this point. We're on YouTube officially, so you can just search Made to Fuel Podcast. Every episode is on YouTube. And as always, you can find us on iTunes, Spotify, and iHeartRadio. Thank you guys for listening, and I will catch you soon on the next episode.
All right, okay, I'm feeling you. All my people in Brooklyn, and you know where hot. I said, we don't stop the body ride. All my people in Queens, in the land in between, said we.